Hi everybody, happy Wednesday and welcome to Build Your Advanced DLIQ. My name is Ashley and with my colleagues Emmy, Bogdan and Jakob, and today's webinar will cover custom connections in Advanced DL 2019. As always, thank you so much for taking time out of your day to be here with us. So before we get started, feel free to leave us questions in the chat window and we'll answer those as best we can. This session is being recorded and the links are available in the registration reminder and the post-webinar survey. All right, and now we have a couple of quick polls that we'd really appreciate your help with. So the first one that we have is, what is your current level of knowledge in Advanced DL? And we'll give everyone about 20 seconds. About 10 more seconds. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and close that. And it looks like 36% are intermediate and 64% are advanced. All right, and our last poll for now is, have you ever used custom connections in your advanced DL projects? And again, we'll give you about 20 seconds. About 10 more seconds. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and close this. And so 64% of you said yes, and 36% said no. Okay, so thank you. All right, so again, today's webinar is about custom connections, and we're going to break the webinar into an introduction to custom connections. So it's going to cover concepts, access to commands, definition methods, then how to use custom connections in Advanced DL. So creating custom connection templates, inserting, copying, visibility settings, deleting, system reference when inserting custom connections, and then we're going to go over some drawing tips. And then, of course, at the end, we'll have some time for a Q&A with Bogdan. All right, Bogdan, are you ready?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so I'm going to change. I'm going to make you the presenter.
Just let me know if you can see my screen.
Okay.
All right, so hello everyone. I hope everyone had a great summer. Thank you for joining us today for our newest webinar in the Build Your Advanced DLIQ series. My name is Bogdan Ciobanu, and I'm part of the Autodesk technical support team. And here at Autodesk, I provide technical support for Advanced DL and BIM 360 products. I will do my best today to help you familiarize yourselves with custom connections if you are new to the topic, or hopefully to improve your knowledge in this specific area if it's not the first time you are using custom connections. As we all know, by definition, custom means something designed or made to meet some particular requirements. And it's actually like that for a specific situation in Advanced DL when the connections available in the connection vault are not enough. We have the possibility to create our own custom connections. So we can define interactive connections different than those available in the connection vault and use them in our project. Even better, as situations that occur might not be unique, and we may want to use those our own configurations at a later time, we can save those custom connections. So, although custom connections are not part of the Advanced DL connection vault, we can store them and we can reuse them at a later time. Where do we find the custom connections in Advanced DL? From the Advanced DL toolkit, on the left-hand side, the third button from top, it's the custom connections button, which will open the panel dedicated to this area. The first two buttons from above will allow us to create new custom connection templates. and to insert custom connections from already existing templates. The other are a set of what we refer to as in Advanced Steel as bricks. They're a set of micro connections, if you want, that will allow us to add objects like plates, studs, stiffeners to our beams and combine them with other already existing connections or other objects in Advanced Steel to create more complex connections. So our custom ones. When it comes to definition methods, there are four methods that distinguish themselves. We have two of them for singular beams, with end and beams with point, and another one for connecting two beams, and the last one for connecting three beams, as per the number of elements that we can connect using a custom connection. It doesn't go further than three at the moment. One beam with end was created as a modality to create custom connections for beams with end plate or base plates. The one with a point, with one insertion point, was meant to for situations when we need to add custom stiffeners, reinforcement plates, or gusset plates. The other two, the names are self-explanatory. We do have the possibility to create two beams, to connect two beams or three beams. For example, in the case of three beams, we can have one main beam and two diagonals, or one main beam and two secondary beams. Right, so without any further introduction, let's take a dive in Advanced Steel and see how everything works in there. So, as mentioned before, from the home button, if we activate our Advanced Steel toolpalette, we find ourselves, we will find the custom connection button, which will open the panel with the options we have there. Let's start our example with a simple column and see how can we customize a custom connection on it. So for this example, I would propose to start from a base plate connection. I designed one already, just to make sure we can move quicker. Right, so in this scenario, I would like to have on my base plate an outside stiffener, but I would like to have it slightly different from what from how it is created in Advanced Steel. So I would like to, instead of having one continuous plate here, and to have this gap between my stiffeners, these two stiffeners here and the flange, I like to have this plate split from one edge of the base plate to the flange, and then have another plate between the flanges, and then a third plate or a second stiffener, if you want, between this flange and the other edge of my base plate. And to do that, let me just quickly close this. Cancel this subset stiffener, so I have my my initial connection. So as I said, a custom connection is meant to allow us to combine every means we have, so like existing predefined or existing connections, the connection vault, objects, features, whatever we have at our disposal. Combine them and create our custom connection, which is what we're going to do now. So to have the plates as I explained, I will first delete my connection box, and then I will have to copy my stiffeners on the base plate. So I'll make sure they're in the right position. Sorry. Right, so I have these two now, and let me make the same thing for the other two. Okay, almost ready, and I need to move this as well. Now for the base, for the plate in between the flanges, I'll just copy this one here and modify it a little. I will need to delete some features on it and to add a new one here. See, I can add features on my objects and have them designed as I wish, and then extend this plate to the column, right? And to move it on the other side, I will just quickly mirror it using the midpoint. Right. So I've added my my new elements to my connection. I just need to make sure that I add the weld and connect these plates to my whole assembly. It is advisable to check that everything is in order before creating the custom template. So I can quickly check and see if I have everything connected. Then maybe why not run a class check to make sure that there are no collisions. And now I am ready to copy my my custom to create my custom connection. So from the custom connection button, if I go to this one here, the first one, create connection template, it will open the definition method dialog. In this case, we'll go from one beam with end, and advanced steel will quickly from task to indicate the beam. After pointing to the beam by simply clicking on it, we'll have the dialog window that will help us set up our connection template. So we'll give it a name. We'll give it a name. Then we have to select the driven output objects, so all the objects that are included in my connection template. Make sure to include all the features, all welds, and all elements. the last thing we need to do here is to choose the driver selection prompt. That's basically referring to what Advanced Steel is prompting us in the command line when creating the connection. After giving this input as well, I'm ready to use my custom connection. So this is my custom connection. The blue box is specific to custom connections, and inside it there are all the objects introduced by this connection. Right. So I have my first template. Let's see how we can spread it across our model. To do that, I will just copy this column a few times. Obviously, the first method is to insert the connection template from the connection template explorer. We have to click on it and then OK. You notice here, select beam. Beam is a text I put in my connection template. After clicking it, I will see my custom connection. Important here, if you want, you notice that there is no blue box displayed, and that is because the visibility for the connection box are controlled by by default in management tools. So if I go to defaults and look for my template under so defaults, joints, general, show custom connection box, there are a few options here. I can choose to never display it. I can choose to display it right after the creation of the custom connection, or only after a modification is done. In my case, it's been set up to be displayed only after I make a modification, like accessing the properties. So Now we have our custom connection visible. If I want to copy it, I can copy it through my usual methods in advanced still. I can insert it, create it by template, or I can create it by, for example, template multiple and have it added to several connections. Very important here about how we can modify the custom connection connections. If I just add one more connection from template here. When it is first added, a custom connection is not allowing us to operate any modifications. So I need to access the connection and then tick this box here, allow object modification, and maybe give it a new name because it will be converted into a new master join. And now after doing this, I'm able to modify everything. So I can change the shape of my objects. I can create features in them. So I'm at liberty to operate modifications. Right. Moving forward. Second option we have. For creating custom connections is the case of the beam with an insertion points. It is designed specifically for stiffeners and postman plates or gusset plates. So let's see how this works. Few things I would like to mention here. For this case, I would like to use the bricks. So we'll see how we can combine the bricks with an existing connection, let's say from the connection vault. I like to use this insertion point for the flanges because it will allow me to easily move. Move these flange plates by simply dragging the point. And then if I were to add another stiffener here, say in the center and choose to have it double, I'm now ready to create my custom template. So, I can choose when creating a custom template to have my to include in it several joints as we're doing now. All right. So for the beam with one insertion point, I need to define the beam and then an insertion point. In this case, I will choose to be the midpoint on this flange here. I need to give it a name. And then I need to indicate the objects that are to be added to my custom connection. And of course, I need to select the driver selection prompts. This would be beam and insertion point. Right, so everything is created. Now I'm able to use and to copy and multiply my connection. So, If I add this custom connection to my beam, when I add it, I will be asked for first beam, second the insertion point. I need to remember where I had my insertion point so that I make sure all the objects are placed correctly. Notice that to have the connection box displayed as I showed earlier, and the same for the joints inside it. I need to trigger an update, a refresh. Of course, I won't be able to edit these joints now, To do that, I will need, of course, to allow the object modification. Very important here, when I have connections inside my custom connection template, the insertion point can be anywhere on this line, right? So because I'm using the connections inside my custom template, this will allow Advanced to calculate and to place all the objects in the correct position, even if the insertion point position is slightly different. It's not the same as I defined it, right? So stiffeners are going to be in the right place. So the only thing that matters is the depth where the plates are positioned with respect to this insertion point. A very important thing here is that when I have a smaller beam than the initial beam for which I created the connection, if I have these joints in my custom template, it will also provide a good result, because Advanced will calculate the size and stiffeners will be in the correct size, and everything will be placed correctly. Let's take another situation now and see what happens if I'm not using these joints. So let me just copy this. If I delete this custom connection here, and I delete these joints as well, and set up a new connection template, beam with one point, again, beam, and midpoint, right? The name. And select the driven output. These are the objects that are to be connected. And again, my driver selection prompts, beam, and insertion point. Right. In this case, if I would like to use my connection template on a beam, I need to be very careful with the insertion point, because if I'm going to place this here, as I'm not using those joints, the insertion point will actually dictate where the objects are placed, so I won't have a good result. So I need to be very careful with insertion point to be the same one as I defined for the connection template. Same thing goes for smaller beams. If I use this template on a smaller beam than the one for which it was created, I won't have a good result, because Advanced Steel won't be able to calculate the new dimensions. So it will just place all the objects correctly if we think about the initial connection template, but for this beam, obviously the result is not going to be great. So important thing here, we need to make sure we have enough connection custom connection templates for our scenarios, right? So if we have different beams, we need to have different connection templates. When it comes to creating custom connection templates for two or three beams, we do have the same rules apply. So the creation process is the same, the insertion process is the same. Copying the custom connection, of course, it's going to be the same. What is very important here is the insertion system reference. So reference system, it will take you, we will have some options here to specify which point is going to be taken into account when creating the custom connection. So let's assume we have this scenario here. I'm going to copy this column and this beam a couple of times, and I will just go ahead and rotate this column here. So for our example, I will assume I'll just create something very simple here, just a plate. And then I will just cut my profile here. So let's assume this is going to be our custom connection. Two beams. Advanced Steel will ask us to specify which is the second, which is the main and the secondary beam. And now we see here we have these three options. This is the intersection of axis reference system. So all the connection templates are going to be inserted with respect to the intersection of axis between the main beam and the secondary beam. This option here will take into account the outer contour or the casing box, as it's referred to as well, of the main beam. And the third one is going to take into account the exact contour of the main beam, and we'll see in a minute what's that about. So let's start with the casing contour. So I'm going to keep a name here. Two beams with outer contour name, and of course I need to specify my drivers. Main beam and secondary beam. Right. What I was saying before, we need to make sure to include everything in our connection. Right. So now I have a prop connection here, taking into account, of course, the cut of the secondary beam. Right. So if we are creating this connection between the column here, Advanced Steel will prompt us between the column and the secondary and the beam here. Advanced Steel will prompt us which is the main and the second, exactly as we defined. Interesting is the situation when the column is rotated, and because we are using the outer contour, you'll see in a minute that that's the contour taken into account. So when my column is rotated, my connection is still going to be created on the outer contour. So this is the outer contour. The connection is created outside this rectangle. Let's go a bit further and see what happens with when we use the other option. So just delete the custom connection here. And if we are to create our custom template using using the exact contour, so give it a name, add the objects to the connection, and then complete the drivers selection prompts. We're now going to be able to use the connection again. Just copy, obviously, the first example will be the same result. Interesting here is going to be to see what's the result when the column is rotated. Exact contour. So as you see, it will take into account the exact contour. So it will go to the column on the exact contour until it finds, it intersects the web of the main element. So we need to be careful. We need to be careful when and how we select our reference systems when creating these custom connections. Right, so let's see the third option here for the system, for the reference system, which is going to be intersection of axes. Quick example as well. I'm creating, let's say, the same scenario with a plate, and shortening. Right, I do have my connection here. Let's create our template. Go two beams, first beam, second beam. Need to select the option of for the reference system, give it a name. Now we should add a driver output object, which is this one, and then the driver selection prompts, main beam and secondary beam. And now we are ready to use our template. Let's just assume we have the same situation once, and then for the other one, I'll just create a gap between the main beam and the secondary beam to see what happens when we apply the custom connection template. So in the first case, obviously the connection is going to be created exactly the same. That's perfectly expected. And then for the second situation, when there is no physical intersection between the two axes, let's see what happens. Advanced Steel will calculate a virtual intersection between the main beam and the secondary beam, and will place the connection in the same position. So basically, this would be a very helpful template when, for example, I need to have some connections at a certain distance between these axes. So if I would have an end plate on this beam here, but the width of the main beam would vary, using this template, I'd make sure that my connections, my elements are always placed at the same distance from the intersection, physical or virtual, between the main beam and the secondary beam. Right. So these would be the options for creating, copying, generating, inserting the connection templates. Now we should go a bit further to see how is the drawing order influence, the drawing direction, how does it influence our custom connection? So I'm going to draw two columns here, one in this direction, one in the opposite direction. And I will want to use the first joint we have created, the first custom template. If I will add this, if I will add this on my columns here, see, it will just put it on the wrong direction for the column. Excuse me, I think it's something wrong here. Just draw this object again. Not sure what's happening, to be honest. I'll need to get back to you on that. Right, so the idea is that when you draw an object it's very important to remember the drawing direction when you have created the connection template. So in this case here, when the drawing direction is the same as it was for the objects on which you created the template, it's going to be well placed. When the drawing direction is changed, is going to place the connection at the wrong end. So when we know we have objects that have been drawn in a different direction, different way, it's always better to have different custom connection templates rather than ending up with wrong results. Same thing goes for, and this is also very important, for objects that are mirrored. So if I am to, let's say, create a quick connection here. Okay, and if I delete this, connection and say I would like to add a new custom template. These are the objects that I want to be added by my connection, and then the driver is going to be BIM. Let's say I'm going to mirror this column here. When I'm adding the custom connection on this object here, it will be obviously added on the wrong direction. So it's very important to make sure that when you have mirrored beams in your advanced field model, you also generate different connection templates. So for the drawing direction custom connections, few takeaway. The drawing direction indeed influences how custom connections are placed on objects. For example, custom connection for beams with endpoint can be very much influenced by the drawing direction start point and end point. If they are different, most probably the results are going to be different. Just realizing that what we've seen before when the custom connection was wrongly placed, it was due to the UCS, because I've changed that when I drew the examples for the intersection of axes for two beams, right? So UCS might also influence the results. We've seen that the orientation can also influence. So mirror objects in general will require a different connection template. And another very important aspect is that the insertion point for beams with one insertion point is highly important if we don't use smart connections inside the custom template. So we've seen how can we model, how can we add, how can we copy, how to work with our custom connections. Let's see how can we save them and where can we save them. So if I go back to my model and open my template explorer, you'll see that all my templates are here. Also, probably you have noticed that I haven't saved anything. So one place where I can store my custom connection templates is inside my model. So as soon as I clear this model, close this model, if I want to use any of the templates here without saving them in a specific location, I won't be able to do that. To do that, I will need to go to save the templates. So normally each template should have should be saved in a known DWG file in Program Data, Autodesk Advanced Web 2019, then depending on the installation package, shared and connection templates. This is the path where the connection templates should be saved in order to be able to use them in other models. Notice that here I can see the sample file, which is also it's also contained in my folder. Another place where we can actually store our connection templates is on a network. If we want to share those connection templates with other members of our organization, we can do that from management tools. There's a default for that path for custom template connections under general. Copy and paste the path there, and when opening the connection explorer, we will be able to see those files in there. Before Q&A, one last thing I'd like to add: how to delete these custom templates. What if I don't want to see them in my model after I've used them? So I don't want to see them in this explorer here. I will just need to go and delete them one by one. So I deleted the first one here, and it's gone from the list. The same thing if I go and delete the one for the mirrored situation, it's going to be out of my list in the browser for templates. So that's pretty much it from my side. I guess we are now open for Q&A if we have any questions. Thank you very much, and I hope you found this webinar helpful and interesting. Ashley?
Thanks, Bogdan. It doesn't look like we have any questions for now, so I can go through the rest of the PowerPoint, and then if there are any questions, we can just come back to those. Is that okay?
Yes, please. Yeah, okay. Of course.
All right, can you see my screen?
Yes.
Okay, all right. So we don't have any questions for now. So if you have any, please feel free to write them in the chat window and we can take a look at those with Bogdan. So we do have an additional resource based on today's webinar. It's from the Autodesk Knowledge Network. There's a page specific to custom connections. So in addition to this webinar, you can also take a look at that as well. And then we have some general additional resources. We have our webinar series, of course, the Autodesk Knowledge Network. We have a lot of great presentations from Autodesk University. We have the Advanced Steel Forum, and we have the Advanced Steel 2018 and 2019 help pages online. And well, as Bogdan said, we really hope everyone enjoyed the webinar, and you can let us know by helping us out with this last poll. So our last poll is, did you find this webinar helpful? And we'll give you about 20 seconds. About 10 more seconds. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and close that. And Bogdan, I think you'll be very happy. Everyone found the webinar helpful. So thank you guys.
Wow, thank you.
All right. So we did have one question come in, and it looks like. So the question is it possible to add beams instead of plates to a beam in a custom connection?
Yeah, so as I said, you you can add pretty much all kind of objects you have, like you've seen on the end plate connection. I have added some anchors, so yeah, it's definitely an option.
And we have another one that just came in. Can you please create a demonstration of a clip angle connection with different size angles on each end? Then he wrote again, each side at the same end.
Right. So what I would say, it's I would just, if I were to do it, I would start it. I think it's easier to start it from scratch. So draw your main beam, draw your secondary beam in their position, and then you should draw your clip angles and bolts, and then add every object to the custom template. So I think that would be the solution. Yeah.
All right. We don't have any more. So thank you guys again so much for joining us today. We wish everyone a great rest of the week, and we look forward to seeing you at our next webinar, and that's going to be on November 14th. And it's going to cover first aid and advanced deal, investigating and troubleshooting. So thanks everyone for joining us, and see you next time.
Thank you. Bye.